Recently, an Illinois state representative from the south side of Chicago suggested that the state ban the sale of video games involving carjackings to curb the cases of real carjackings in the city of Chicago that have been plaguing the city for almost a year, sometimes in broad daylight. The suggestion reignited that age-old dumb debate that video games are a direct cause of violence and also brought the conversation of Chicago's crime issues to a national stage. But this isn't Chicago's first run-in with Grand Theft Auto. Welcome to Local Pixels, the series that talks about Chicago's contribution to video games. And while the series has aimed to celebrate Chicago's positive contributions, it should be noted that Chicago, like other cities, don't always land on the right side of history with video games. For example, Roger Ebert, a legendary movie critic, is from Chicago, and he had an absolutely terrible take on video games as an art form. In fact, I did a video on it a while back. Chicago is no stranger to banning stuff that young people use to muck up the city. If you come to Chicago and want to buy a can of spray paint, for example, from Michaels, you'll notice that there's no section for it within city limits. It's actually been illegal here for the past 30 years, and yet there's still graffiti all over the city. Now, I don't want to get too political in this video, but people from outside of Chicago tend to have a very warped perspective of the inner workings of Chicago and the politics that run the city. It's pretty complicated, but I can assure you that we aren't run by Al Capone and his goons, and despite the crime that occurs in the city, it's not like it's Mad Max over here. That being said, Chicago and Illinois in general have a lot of political theater here, and it really only serves to frustrate its citizens. Introducing State Representative Marcus Evans, first appointed to the state Congress in 2012, and he attributed the rising number of carjackings in the city of Chicago to, you guessed it, video games, and he wants to ban them, and not just in Chicago, in the entire state of Illinois. On February 19, 2021, Marcus Evans submitted HB 3531, which aims to amend an existing state law that up until now just prohibited the sale of violent video games to minors. But if you're a parent or guardian and you buy it for the minor, that's okay, and if the game is anything under M for mature, then that's okay too. So the bill is pretty toothless, so I don't even think people actually knew this existed. Which makes this amendment pretty dumb in and of itself. The main reason being is that I'm an adult and I should be able to buy any game that I want, and any other adult over the age of 18 should as well. And it would be pretty hypocritical to ban the sale of violent video games when the studio which makes arguably the most violent video game ever, Mortal Kombat, resides in the state of Illinois. Also, if you look at the 33rd ward that Mr. Evans presides in, you'll know that he really is out of touch. It butts right up to the border of Indiana. And you know what else is illegal in Illinois? Fireworks with a rapport, i.e. anything with a boom, which means that we can only buy fireworks that are sparklers, poppets, and those little smoke snakes. But you know what the first week of July sounds like in Chicago? And do you know what state sells those fireworks? If you guessed Indiana, you'd be correct. I mean, Wisconsin also sells them, but Indiana is closer to Chicago, and it really emphasized my point. If people want something bad enough, they'll just drive across the border to get it. And while you're over there, instead of paying $14 for a pack of cigarettes, why not get a pack in Indiana for a third of that? And fill up your gas tank as well, because gas is much cheaper there also. Time will tell if this bill passes, and I really think that it was a publicity stunt, because Mr. Evans, if you look at his law history, all he does is amend existing laws, and pretty much they're correcting grammar. But like I mentioned at the top of the video, this isn't the first time that Chicago dare challenge Grand Theft Auto. In April of 2008, before the release of Grand Theft Auto 4, Rockstar poured a lot of money into advertising, as you do for big releases. Rockstar spent $300,000 to advertise Grand Theft Auto 4 on Chicago's mass transit system, the Chicago Transit Authority, or the CTA for short. This is an example of one of those ads. Pretty harmless, but not for Fox News. It took me a bit to track down the original article, but thanks to the Wayback Machine, I was able to find the original article, but sadly I can't find the video because they used Flash in 2008, so an article snapshot will have to do. So basically what happened was that the local Fox News affiliate asked the head of the CTA why they're allowing violent video games to be advertised to children, and instead of the CTA telling the Fox News affiliate, hey, we don't have any money and we'll take what we can get, they pulled those ads immediately and banned further violent video game ads from being advertised in the future, citing a correlation between the violence in video games and actual real-world violence, which is really unfounded and actually something that the original state law that I mentioned earlier also cites. So they pulled the ads and crisis averted, right? Well, no, because Rockstar sued the CTA for breach of contract and the CTA was forced to put those ads up for free around Christmas time, which added a bit more of a boost to Grand Theft Auto 4. So the winner definitely wasn't the children in this case.
And it didn't end there. In early 2010, a federal court found that the ordinance the CTA enacted to prohibit the advertisements of M and AO rated video games was a violation of the First Amendment, since the CTA is a municipal service, and cited that the CTA trains and buses have already been found to be a public forum where free speech is protected. And since that federal injunction, mature rated games have been advertised on CTA areas, specifically for the new Mortal Kombat with the tagline, Made in Chicago.
Also, surprise, crime hasn't really gone down in the past 13 years despite taking down those advertisements. And also, the spike in carjackings happened just a couple years ago, and Grand Theft Auto has been out since 2012. But hey, why solve your social problems when you can just blame it on video games? So that's gonna do it for this episode of Local Pixels. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up and share it with those who might find it interesting. And if you're interested in Local Pixels, I have one official episode for you to view on the unreleased Power Up Baseball from Midway, and I have more episodes planned, so consider subscribing for future content. You can also follow me on Twitter and Instagram at snicktendo. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Super Nicktendo, and I'll see you next time.